Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I am Muhammad Furqan, student from University Sains Islam of Malaysia. I will present about the topic analysis of the effectiveness of productive zakat utilization in empowering mustahik and micro enterprise. First, I would like to discuss about the abstract. Poverty is a significant economic issue faced by Indonesia. Zakat not only serves to help but also empowers the needy, with the aim that the empowered mustahik beneficiaries can become muzaki or the donors. Optimizing zakat funds involves not only providing monetary benefits but also offering micro, small and medium business capital along with the training and mentorship. Productive zakat currently offer can create economic independence, for example, by providing capital to start business, allowing individuals to begin their enterprise and increasing their income. This qualitative research employs thematic data analysis and triangulation. Data collection method include interviews, documentation, and observation. Introduction. Determining the pouring insight is to use the personal skills approach to meet basic needs. The number of poor people in Indonesia based on the data from Central Bureau of Statistics or BPS in 2022 will reach 26,160,000 people, or equivalent to 10%, when referring the percentage of Indonesia population about 2,275,361,267 people. Statistic 2022. And also the majority of Indonesian population is Muslim. Indonesia is a country with a Muslim majority population, so the potential of zakat in helping poverty alleviation effort is even higher. Furthermore, Sadiq 1986 explained that Islam development also has an important role in tackling poverty because the problem is a moral and social responsibility. Poverty is a big problem and has been around for a long time, and it becomes a reality in life. Islam views the problem of poverty as a problem is not meeting primary needs as well. Islamic law has determined the primary needs are in the form of three things, namely clothing, food and housing. My research objective is to investigate the distribution of productive zakat funds at the Lembaga Zakat Sukses Depok. Second, to analyze the effectiveness of productive zakat utilization at the Lembaga Zakat Sukses Depok. And third, to identify the challenge in managing the productive zakat programs at the Lembaga Zakat Sukses Depok. The territory view. The distribution of zakat can be categorized into types. The first, productive zakat, where the collected zakat funds are allocated to support the business of mustahik and to help them grow and eventually enable them to pay zakat, infaq, and sadaqah in the future. Second, consumptive, where zakat funds are provided in consumptive manner to meet the daily basic needs of mustahik. The existence of zakat, initially aimed at eradicating poverty, has led to new thought and innovation in the distributing of zakat funds, such as supporting productive enterprises. Referring to the conceptual foundation of zakat utilization systematically categorized by Dawood Ali, traditional consumptive zakat, creative consumptive zakat, traditional productive zakat, creative productive zakat. As in the case with the productive zakat, guidance is needed so that mustahik can achieve the greater level of success according to the expectation of mustahik and business. Later, Qardul Hassan, discussing the issue of zakat, distribution of zakat for the capital needs of the poor, is not a new topic, especially when distribution is given directly to the mustahik and there is no disagreement among scholars about it. However, if this distribution is carried out through the contract of Al-Qardul Hassan, interest-free loan, and distribution of productive zakat capable of managing this distribution, the nature of trustworthiness means having the courage to be responsible for all the activities it carries out, which includes honesty, while professional is the nature of being able to carry out the task assigned to him with exacting scientific capital. Methodology. The study employs a qualitative research. Qualitative research is a research using methods such as participant observation or case study, which result in a narrative descriptive account of a setting of or a practice. Sociologists using these methods typically reject positivism and adopt a form of interpretive sociology. The researcher visit the research to the research site to observe directly and document the events occurring to obtain data on how productive zakat is utilized in the zakat success institution. The interview method is a form of conversation and art of asking and listening. Methodology. This study used both closed and open interviews. In closed interviews, the interviewer are unaware that they are being interviewed and do not know the purpose of the interview. The analysis involves three main activities: data reduction, data display, and conclusion drawing. The analysis follows the interactive model as described by Marsh and Huberman. Data analysis technique used in this qualitative research is the analysis technique proposed by Marsh and Huberman. Thematic analysis is a method used to analyze data with the aim of identifying patterns or discovering themes from the data collected by the researcher. Finding. Last finding, the process of receiving productive zakat for beneficiaries involves several stages: joining the consumer cooperative group inspiration by successful mothers, attending weekly meetings organized by the institution. After 5 weeks of membership, participants must take a loan, at least 500 rupiah, with a Qardul Hasan contract. Business proposal submission and feasibility survey, and participating in training, guidance, and supervision conducted by the zakat institution. The productive zakat utilization by the zakat institution includes training, guidance, and supervision. The training provided involves practical management, financial management, simple advertising, creating using videos or photos, and how to properly cook fried chicken. Weekly monitoring meetings are also held to motivate beneficiaries in their business. In force, the zakat institution regularly supervises the operational aspect of the beneficiary's business. Third, the challenge faced by mistake in implementing the productive zakat program include financial management issues such as managing funds for business capital, operational expense, saving, and daily needs. Beneficiaries also struggle with calculating daily profit and analyzing business progress. And the zakat institution faces the challenge in providing suitable guidance and training due to the diversity of business run by beneficiaries or by mustahik. Okay, thank you. This is all for my topic journal. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.